episode 1677, Play to Your Strengths.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy every day. What would happen with your wellness journey if somebody came to you and said, play to your strengths? Do you think it would give somewhat of a relief that you wouldn't have to put as much effort into it? Let's dive in. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, living a healthy lifestyle takes daily work and repetitive action. Play to your strengths to bring balance in your everyday. There are times we overcomplicate life. We want something one way, but go about it a different way, only to find out that there was even a more direct route, a more direct way than any of the others we were considering. Living a healthy lifestyle requires us to be living and make wise choices. Be honest with yourself. Are you doing that right now today? Okay, what are you putting in your mouth? What are you drinking? Are you making wise choices? Are you living the best selfie that you can live? We all have room for improvement, but a lot of us fall short of that improvement. Why? Because we're going about it the wrong way. If there are choices that we grew up with, then we have no problem making good choices, right? We can make wise choices. It's easy. We got it. But for all those choices that must change in order to get the results we desire, this becomes a little more challenging. This is where we hit the bumps in the road. And when challenge is present, so is doubt. How many times have you tried something and you've fallen short? You failed. When you go back and try it again, does it make it easier to try it again? Or are you a little more timid? Are you taking less risk in order to reach what you're looking for because you've already had a result that you didn't like? Our body prefers to do what it knows. When you decide to shake up what's imbalanced, then you have trouble on the horizon. Your mind starts to play tricks on you, right? You'll come up with any excuse or you'll see things one particular way. It'll just jump out at you all the time. Maybe you find ways to not do what you're trying to do. Okay, not only are there excuses, but you're like, oh no, if I go that direction, then I can reason out that this might happen. Oh, and this might too, so I'm just going to stay away with it. Or you ignore what comes natural. You're just like, no, I'm done. You're in a mess, a really, really big mess. Instead of uprooting all that you know and inserting more chaos, chaos draws up what? Confusion. You don't want to add confusion into something that you're trying to change. So find ways to play to your strengths. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Play to your strengths. Most changes that are needed come from what? A weakness. We try to go about it the wrong way. We want to change what we don't know, what needs to be improved. If you were not a good reader in kindergarten, what do people work on? You becoming a good reader. Instead of going, wait, you know some of these words. Let's work on these words while we also work on this. Oh, no, but we look at just, oh, she doesn't know all of these words, so we just have to really work hard here. It makes you uncomfortable. You already feel like a failure before you start. No wonder you're having difficulty. And what happens as first grade comes along, second grade comes along, third grade comes along, you feel like you're falling back more and more and more. You're not getting ahead of the game. Reading is not becoming easier. It's still a challenge because it's a weakness. Play to your strengths instead. Number one, do what you do best. Look at your quirks and habits. And yes, I use that great word, quirks. You got to look at the good, the bad, and the ugly, all of it. Focus on what you do best. Mind over matter. When you overthink, you underperform. So if you are wanting something different than what you have now, look at what you do best. Focus on that instead of going, okay, I really got this bad thing with sweets and I'm just going to hit the sweets running. I got to cut out all sugar. I got to cut out all donuts. I got to cut out all cakes. I got to cut out anything that has sugar in it. I got to cut it all out. It may not even fall into the sweet category, but it's got sugar. I'm cutting it out. That's not going to last real long. You can do it for a little while. You can have that all-in atmosphere. And you're like, oh, yeah, I got this hardcore. But later on, what happens? You go back to your old ways. And there you are again. You're back in your weakness. So do what you do best. When you overthink, you underperform. Also, I want you to be careful not to overexert or overcompensate yourself on a weakness. Look at those quirks, look at your habits, and focus on what you do best, and then rinse and repeat. Number two, eat what you enjoy that is the healthiest of choices. Now, anybody can say, I want to live a healthy lifestyle, and immediately you think of two things, or at least I do. So I'm going to tell you what they are. Exercise and food. Fitness, food. I don't care how you put what words together. None of them ring awesomeness to me. Oh no. I'm like, really? That means you're going to deprive me and then you're going to make me work harder than what I already am working. Like I have time for that. So remove that from your equation. Eat what you enjoy that is the healthiest of choices. So right now, if you're eating majority of what? Boxed CRAP, and you're eating out of the pantry instead of eating out of the refrigerator, then think of what you do have in the refrigerator that you enjoy that you can eat more of and really pulls you away from the pantry. So instead of trying to convince yourself that foods you don't like are foods that you do like, eat what is good for you that you already love. It's that simple. Start there. Now, I'm not saying that's the only place to go. These are your what? First steps. These are your baby steps. One step at a time leads to miles of greatness. This isn't the whole map of how you're going to stay healthy for a lifetime, but you have to start somewhere. So eat what you enjoy that is the healthiest of choices. And finally, number three, move to the beat of your drum. Movement is key. We need to do it more. We sit way too often, so get moving. Don't try to beat yourself up with trying new things that don't interest you. Do what you enjoy. What is it that you enjoy? If you're a runner and you've been a runner all your life and people are saying, oh, running's not good for you, you really need to add in strength training. Well, you know what? If running is your thing, then run. You can add in strength training later. Yes, it's important. You need to build muscle. But if you are saying, yeah, but I'm just trying to get a little healthier and I really like running, then run. If you are healthy enough, meaning your joints can handle the pressures that you will put when you're striking one foot with the other foot and you are moving at a faster tempo than just walking, then run. There's nothing wrong with that. Now, do you need to add in some other forms of movement? Yes, but you don't have to start there. You see, that's when our mind goes, oh my gosh, what are you doing to me? I can't handle this. There's too much change. I'm not used to this. Your body's freaking out. Your mind is freaking out. Your soul's freaking out. Your spirit's going, I'm just done. And all you want to do every morning is not get up because it's all this other stuff that you don't know that doesn't feel good that you're telling yourself you have to do. So stop doing all that stuff and making things crazy for yourself. Don't do it. Play to your strengths. Move to the beat of your drum. Nothing is more frustrating and spells defeat, D-E-F-E-A-T, faster than forcing the all in effect with things that you don't like or you don't do well. All it says is you are finished, and it's not the right finish line you're wanting in your health journey. Play to your strengths, which in turn will give you a greater chance at achieving the goals you desire. Now, we don't have it all right in our life. We don't know everything. We don't do everything right. We all fall short some day, some moment, or another. And when we're on this thing called health, and we're on this journey, this path, that we want to have this incredible body so we can really take care of the ones that we love, right? We have to have a body to support that. If you don't have your health, you don't have wealth. I don't care how much money you have. It doesn't matter. You've got to have your health. It's a quality of life. You don't just want to be alive. You want to be able to participate by being alive. So when you look at your health journey, when you look at your wellness and your well-being, who you are as a whole person, mind, body, and spirit, you've got to look at all different avenues. This one avenue that we're talking about today is specifically regarding the body. How are you taking care of the body? How are you fueling your body? What are you putting in it? How are you moving your body? How do you actually keep it functioning on a daily basis? And how is your mind controlling all of the stuff that's happening in life? All the stress that's coming at you? I mean, think about it. You know the game, you get to go and you get to pay lots of money and people throw things at you. It's called paintballs. And you come out all colorful. Do you know in life, we have stress balls being thrown at us on a daily basis? If we could have that stress be resembled with a paintball at us, and we come home every day with this magic mirror and look at it, how colorful would you be? Well, I think, honestly, most of us would be way too colorful. We're all way too stressed. There's so much going on in our family life, in our business life, in our community life, and beyond. We look at the world that we touch, and then we look at the world just around us. You turn on the TV or however you consume your daily news as to what's going on in the world. And maybe you don't turn it on because you don't want to know because it stresses you out. That's more paintballs. You don't want those stress balls. You don't need any more color. You're trying to calm yourself down. Play to your strengths. Don't add stress. This is a tough thing to do. I know. I live it on a daily basis. And it takes a lot of work. It takes a lot of effort. And it takes a lot of energy. And in some cases, it's equivalent to a full-time job. So if you have one child, that's one full-time job. If you have two children, that's two full-time jobs. If you have a spouse, that's another full-time job. If you actually have a job outside of the household, that's a full-time job. Plus, you run a household, that's a full-time job. Do you know how many full-time jobs you have? A ton. It can become overwhelming to the point that all you see when you look in this magic mirror is colorful stress. It's a face of defeat. It's a heart that says, I'm tired. I can do no more. I don't want you to reach that point in your well-being. I don't want you to feel defeated when you have greatness before you. If you at all are questioning that today, click on the link, take aim in the show notes. I have a free gift for you. It's a coaching call with me. Life is rough and tough, but you don't have to do it alone. Click on that link and that will begin our conversation. You know, on my health journey, it's been a roller coaster. At times, man, it's been smooth sailing. And I just want to yell and scream with happiness, like, yeah, I'm having the ride of my life. And other times I'm like, just stop and let me get off. I'm done. And other times I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm so sick of this. Why can't I figure it out? There is no one answer to well-being. You have to figure out what you need for your life. Don't live with the markings of stress all over yourself. Don't add more chaos to your everyday. Play to your strengths, which in turn will give you a greater chance at achieving the goals you desire. One step at a time leads to your miles of greatness. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Cheers to a wonderful day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.